Fantastic. And thanks for staying up with us, folks. The battle over prayer and its place in school is not over this legislative session. In fact, the House and Senate have both passed bills ensuring students could pray at school events. 16 WAPT's Aaron Kelly is live outside the state capitol with this story. Good evening, Aaron.
Good evening, Scott. And supporters say that these bills should ensure religious freedom and that they would clear up what is allowed at schools. But the ACLU says it's concerned that this could lead to some students being forced to listen to other students' religious expressions.
We pray over tests, everything. So I don't feel like it shouldn't be any type of separation between school and religion, because it doesn't affect anything.
Lanier High School student DeMarcus LaFleur says he's not bothered by two bills that would allow students to get up over the loudspeaker and say a prayer.
The student wants to present a paper on their hero, and their hero happens to be Jesus Christ, then a student has the right to write that paper and to present that paper to the class.
Prayers should be in schools, in every school.
The House and Senate have both passed bills on the issue. They include language declaring morning announcements and football games limited public forums. The ACLU says that could violate the separation of church and state.
What they can't do is force everyone else to listen to them praying. And so the court said, we can't insist people be held captive.
Last year, the ACLU went after West Lincoln Attendance Center in Lincoln County over prayers on the loudspeaker and at school-sponsored events. Under these bills, schools would publish disclaimers they are not sponsoring prayer.
By setting up that forum, by giving the use of, you know, the loudspeaker, of school time, of all of that, it still puts that print of, you know, stamp of approval on it.
You're going to have certain parents complaining and certain parents that are not complaining. That's going to cause a conflict.
The first year that the Senate has passed such a bill, both the House and the Senate will have to agree on a version of the bill before it could be sent to Governor Bryant. Live outside the state capitol, Aaron Kelly, 16 WAPT News.
Real quick though, Aaron, what are state educators saying about this bill?
Sam Bounds, who's the head of the superintendents for the state, says he does have some concerns that this could put schools in conflict with federal law. Scott.
Could be heading to the